are sanctified by the abiding word. John 15, verses 1, 2, and 3. I am the true wine, and my Father is the wine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. You are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. In John 15, Jesus is portraying our relationship with him through the picture of the vine and the branches. And in verse 2, he relates that to our lives, where he says, you know, every branch that is bearing fruit, the wine dresser, what he does is he prunes it so that it can bear more fruit. So the pathway or the secret to bearing more fruit is pruning, taking off the unnecessary things. And right after that, in verse 3, Jesus says, you know, this pruning, this cleansing, this removing of unnecessary things happens through my word. Because he says in verse 3, you are already clean. You have already been pruned. In your life, all the unnecessary things up until this stage has already been dealt with. How? You are clean through the word that I have spoken to you. So he's revealing to us that the word of God is God's pruning agent, if you will. It's God's cleaning agent that he cleans. He takes off the unnecessary things in our lives so that we can be more fruitful. And then he calls that word there is sanctify. You are sanctified, already cleaned, cleansed. You're sanctified, you're made clean. How? To the word that I have spoken. In John 17 and verse 17, Jesus said, Lord, sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. So he's praying and he's saying, God, sanctify them, clean them up, set them apart, make them holy by your truth. And he says, your word is truth. So the word of God has this cleaning effect, this sanctifying effect, this pruning effect, so that we can be more fruitful. So you see how important it is to have the word of God abiding in us richly. Maybe you're in a certain level of fruitfulness. I mean, things are going well in your life and you're being fruitful. You're bearing fruit for the kingdom of God. You're being successful in what you're doing. You're glorifying Christ in your life. All of that is wonderful, but God doesn't say, well, if you're somewhat fruitful, I'll let it be there. What Jesus said is, every branch in me that bears fruit, he prunes it so it can bear more fruit. In other words, God is saying, let's go up higher. Let's go to the next level of fruitfulness. Let's see increased fruitfulness in life, in your life. But the way to get there is by his abiding word, because it's that word that prunes us. It's that word that takes away the unnecessary things. It's that word that comes in like a cleansing agent, a sanctifying agent, taking away those unnecessary things so that we can move to a higher level of fruitfulness. I want to encourage you, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, because it's that word that moves you up to greater fruitfulness as it works in you and me. Let's pray. God, we thank you for the power of your word, that it cleanses us, it prunes us, it pushes us to new levels of fruitfulness. Enable us to have that word dwelling in us richly. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.